everybody. I've got Riaz with me today, and we are going to be talking about the customer experience and how data-driven insights are driving that as we move forward. But before we dive into the questions that I have for you, can you give everybody an introduction?
Hi, Emma. Thanks for having me. A pleasure to be here. My name is Riaz Raihan. I'm the president at Alida, running our R&D organization, which includes engineering, products, UX, and cloud. I come from a background in software. I've been in the software business for about 2 decades, working at companies like SAP and Cisco and Infor. And I've been at Alida now for just over a year in the CX space.
Wonderful. Thank you. So my first question for you, I mentioned we're talking about customer experience, but can you share a little about your views on how customer experience should be playing into the larger idea of digital transformation?
It's a great question. And digital transformation encompasses, you know, many different facets of any business. And one of the most important facets of a business is how they manage the experience of customers or subscribers that are using that product or service. And if you think about it, you know, why is this super important now as we get into 2021? Well, there's a couple of reasons for it. Reason number one is that almost every business, whether it's a technology business or a consumer products business, or even a retail business, they're all trying to become subscription businesses, right? Amazon wants you to have Prime, Costco needs a subscription. So subscription is very important. If you're consuming cable content or music, you're usually a subscriber. So in a subscription economy, maintaining customer subscribers is super important. It's not a one and done. You need them to renew their subscriptions on an ongoing basis. And the single biggest factor that drives that renewal rate is the customer experience. Customers that don't have a great experience tend to leave. The technical term is churn. And customers that do have a great experience tend to stay on, tend to buy more, tend to get, you know, greater subscriptions, tend to invite their friends and family. So for all those reasons, this plays a huge role in digital transformation. Now, the second factor is the availability of mobile technology. And I think the pandemic has made this even more prevalent. The ability to work remotely, you're doing this right now on video conferencing as an example. And the third factor is social media, because social media contains all our opinions, whether you like them or not. And the combination of these three forces has made CX or CXM, customer experience management, extremely relevant in digital transformation. Companies now know that it's not enough to just sell to a customer or to make them a customer. It's extremely important to retain them over a period of time. And I think that's why there's such a big buzz around CXM.
Great, thank you. I've never heard it put quite in that position of the subscription side, but as I was thinking when we were talking about it, all of my favorite brands have somehow gotten me to engage in some sort of subscription or loyalty program or something that keeps me wanting to come back for more. Now, when we take a look at this customer experience, how do you think that data-driven insights are going to shape the way that we interact with our customers moving forward?
So when you get a little tactical and you say, how do you do CX? So how do you do good CXM? Well, you have to solve for two problems. The first problem is, how do you go broad? And what I mean by that is, how do you go out? Let's assume you are a C-level executive at a large company that has millions of customers. You obviously want to go broad, and you want to make sure that you're getting feedback from all those millions, right? Ideally, you don't want to leave anyone out. If someone's interacted with your brand or consumed a service, that's an event. You want to trigger either a survey or a micro survey or some other form of feedback, or maybe a social media feed, and get immediate feedback on whether that customer liked it or didn't like it. Sometimes just the act of listening demonstrates empathy, which is one of our core values. And that empathy could be the difference between keeping or losing that customer, right? So that's vector number one. We call that broad feedback. The second dimension to this problem is the deep insight. Now that you've got broad feedback, you want to be able to go deep, especially when there are problems to be solved. So let's assume, just for the sake of this discussion, that you happen to be a C-level executive of a large company that ships curated clothing to people. Now, as they get their clothing, they might have a variety of issues. They might not like the curation, or they might like it. They might have shipping issues, or they might have, let's just say, issues with billing. And let's say the big issue that you're seeing as a result of the broad feedback is around shipping. And you're seeing a trend here. Now you want to be able to dig into the trend and you want to be able to go deep and say, what can I do to fix that problem? That's when the deep insights comes in. You want to take a subset of your full breadth of customers, have that subset of curated customers that you can go to, your advisor, so to speak, and say, hey, you 10,000 people represent all of my millions of customers. What is this issue and how can I solve for it? Right. So think about the broad feedback as being, more of a dipstick, getting a temperature check on how your customers' experiences are going. But once you have that, you want to be able to go deep and actually get prescriptive and actually understand the problem so you can solve them and then take the solution and go back and apply it to the millions. Right. It's kind of like the vaccine. Right. To solve for the vaccine, what did the pharma companies do? They took a small group of people. They tried it out on them. They tested it, and now that it's ready to save the world. CX works much the same way. You got to have the broad feedback, but you have to be able to go deep.
Now, can you share a little bit about the work that you and the team at Alida are doing to bring artificial intelligence into these insights and help shape the customer experience?
So let's go back to our example, our previous example, when you were reaching out to millions of customers, right? So if you're an executive in a large company, there's no way you can have armies of people sitting around, sending out surveys and capturing the responses and understanding what people are saying and looking at trends, doing things like text analytics, which is taking the words and then figuring out keywords. And all of that today can be done by artificial intelligence. And that's how our company is built. We use AI to send out trigger-based surveys or trigger-based touch points or trigger-based activities. We use AI to capture the feedback. So when the feedback comes in, either through text or perhaps a video, one of your customers or many of your customers use video, just talk into their phone and give you that feedback. Transcribing that, looking at the keywords, looking at the facial, the emotion recognition, compiling all of that, that's a lot of work, right? Those are multiple touch points across millions of customers. You're looking literally at hundreds of millions, perhaps billions of data points. And it's humanly impossible and inefficient to do it just with people. So AI plays a big role in doing this work. And what the AI does is, while maintaining privacy, we take that very seriously, while maintaining privacy and confidentiality and security, capture the right information at the right time with the consent of folks, bring that in and present the trends back to an internal audience, an internal executive team, who can then take that input and go improve their products and services. So AI is playing a huge role. And I think without the progress that the world has made in AI, I don't think we would be as far advanced in CX as we are today. And as an example, our company is completely infused with AI. I have a team of about 20 engineers within my R&D organization that is focused exclusively on AI, right? And that's a big investment and it's paying off. It pays off every day.
Well, I appreciate you joining me to share a little bit on your thoughts of that customer experience and how this industry is changing our world. For anybody that's interested in learning a little bit more, please head on over and check out Riaz and your LinkedIn as well as Alida and figure out what you guys are doing and ask any questions that you have directly to him. But thank you for your time today and have a wonderful day, everyone.
Thank you, Emma.